Yo, mic check, 1, 2.
2, 1, 2.
My name is Luis Armando Saravia. I was diagnosed with rhabdomyosarcoma in August, and I was admitted here at the Oakland Children's Hospital, and I started treatment on September 3rd. Rhabdomyosarcoma is a lymph node infection. I was starting to swell up here. It was spreading up this way. It started out in my wrist, I guess. Maybe you can see the burn from the radiation. Made its way up to my chest. You feel sick. Wake up in the morning, throw up. Wake up in the morning, you try to reach the bathroom, but you can't because your feet are really weak. You gotta take all these medicines, get shots.
I think probably the hardest part might have been the radiation. That's when more pain kicks in. Knowledge yourself is like life after death. That you never worry about your last breath.
Death comes, that's how I'm living. It's the next stage, the flesh goes underground. I write a lot. I write a lot of lyrics, a lot of music.
2,000 milligrams Vicodin, 2 Benadryls, and I'm sipping NyQuil.
Once you get a beat to it, it's really a song.
Young Rider, your boy stay savage. Give me this, that Benjamin Fresh. I gotta live lavish. I put it past me, let my wounds heal as they flow through my veins. Cuts wide open, let them drip and flow down the drain. Let your pain stain the streets like the rain. But open your eyes and appreciate more. While you fantasize, just make you hallucinate more. Don't let your tears drown your eyes unless you can hear all your fears through your ears. Oh, and it's deep, so deep, make you bleed in your sleep. Lick your lips and taste the words that you speak. Don't be surprised that others when they wipe a kiss off their cheek, as you're not surprised at yourself when you speak.
That is excellent.
And then he asked me to read some of his poetry, some of his music, some of his lyrics, and I thought it was great, and I thought that he should do something with it.
Take it to the next level?
Yeah, take it to the next level.
Got like 6 lines going into me every night. Being that as it may, I can still handle all this pressure. Gotta stay positive, you know, keep a smile on my mom. There's a lot more I gotta do in this life.
I'd like to introduce two of my nurses, Hannah and Allison. They're two very great people. They take great care of me.
I also forgot to mention, definitely gotta stay positive for my brother, my best friend, Victor. The most important time in history is now, the present. So count your blessings,
cause time can't define the essence, but you're stressing over time and you follow the road. Those who you really want to be there aren't always gonna be there. You gotta learn to accept that. Cause if you don't, it's really gonna bring you down. You kind of grow up, kind of shift gears into this whole new person, to this whole new mentality. I believe that this, if you don't let it break you, it's only gonna make you into much a better person. You will understand more. And think about what's really important. You think about who you want to be, what you want to be, what you want to be remembered for. My main goal is try to maintain my positive outlook on things. And even if I do, I do cry at times, you know. It's sad and depressing. You don't want to be here. Just to make everybody around me laugh makes me feel better. Just to make sure everybody else around me is keeping a smile on helps me keep a smile on. That's really what I use to cope with this.
Now, for those of you who think that this is the end, this isn't. This is only the beginning.
Once this is all over, there's gonna be something great waiting for me at the finish line. I feel like I can do anything and nothing can stop me, even though I'm plugged up to an IV. Yes, yes. My words may not convey just what I